So last year I did an online tournament series. We had three events, and out of those three qualifying events, I had a championship tournament where we actually gave away a boat. If you want to participate in my online fishing tournament series, it's very easy to join. All you have to do is register for the tournament on my website, shopbelat.com. Make a purchase on the website and you're in the event. We give away a bunch of tackle, rods, reels, baits, hard baits. We give away apparel every month in my online tournament series. And if you qualify for the championship at the end of the year, you got a chance to win a boat. This year we gave away a Hobie Passport 12. So it's an easy way for you guys to get introduced and get your feet wet into the world of tournament fishing. All right, for the last few weeks, I've been breaking down the chatterbait and talking, just diving into the specifics of what I like to use, where I like to throw it, and really reeling in all of the big subject of chatterbait fishing, trying to make it very short, compact, and simple. We're gonna talk today about the reels that I like to use. This is what I wanna try to accomplish in this video right here. Number one, before I even get into what's the best chatterbait reel for you guys to use, there's really no such thing as a chatterbait reel. I wanna make sure I make that clear. Now there's reels that I like that I feel help me fish a chatterbait better. There's really no such thing as a chatterbait reel. So don't go to the store looking for that. Number two, what I wanna accomplish in this video is I wanna help you choose the best reel that you have to fish a chatterbait. So not really trying to get you to go to the store this Friday and buy a chatterbait reel to fish this Saturday. Wives, y'all can thank me for that. Thirdly, I think I'm on number three. If you're looking to fish a chatterbait or buy a chatterbait reel, I want to just give you a few suggestions on what I've found to work really, really good for me when fishing a chatterbait. That's all I want to accomplish in this video, okay?
God, dude, that's a giant. Lock it.
Yeah. That one locked it, dude.
There's really only about three things that I look for in a good chatterbait reel. It's not that complicated. None of these things that I'm about to tell you are super groundbreaking. And none of them, you'll be able to find these attributes in just about every reel out there. I've got right here in front of me, these are the reels that I've used over the years. This is an old Corrado, probably 15-year-old Shimano Corrado. 13 Fishing Inceptions, one I started using last year for spinnerbait. This is also an old Shimano Corrado 200G. Listen to it. Here's another 13 Fishing. This is the Concept A. One of my favorites I don't have right now. I don't know. I guess I got rid of them. I sold them. Was the Lose Tournament Pro. Three things that I'm looking for in the chatterbait reel. First of all, it's got to be a slower reel to be a chatterbait reel. When I say slower, that's gonna be like something in the sixes, 6, 8, 1. I don't like anything sevens and eights. Almost all our reels, what's driving the reel market right now is the faster reels. But some of these techniques, you really are hurting yourself not using a slower reel. Everybody always tells me that, well, when I throw my chatterbait, I can slow down better than I can speed up. I'm trying to think of a nice PG-rated way to say this to my fellas out here. You can't slow down, bro. If you think you can slow down, I'll put it to you this way. I got three kids because I couldn't slow down. That makes sense? You think you're slowing down, you are not slowing down. And if you're not slowing down, or if your mind is on how slow you're going, your mind is not in the right place. Because the last thing you need to do, you need to be able to control all things you can control. And when you're fishing, your mind should not be on your reel speed so much. You need to be thinking about, where's my next cast going to be? What am I feeling on the end of my line? Where's the next place that I'm going to move? As a tournament fisherman especially, my mind does not need to be focused on how slow. We've got equipment to take care of that for you. That's the reason you, that's one of the reasons you need to slow down. Secondly, chatterbait is a super busy bait. Put it down in the water, you feel the thump, you can see it in the tip, you can see it. It's got a lot of action. You don't maximize the action of the bait if you've got a super fast reel. Another thing, I've watched this. I was a fishing guide for about 3 years. People would throw the chatterbait out and they just aimlessly just wind it back to the boat. The bait never gets down to where the fish are because they're just aimlessly just winding it back to the boat. Wind. Just bringing it back to the boat. The bait would never get down below 18 inches. And a chatterbait is a bait that will tend to rise through the water column the faster you reel it. We got a tool to help you with that. We've got slower gear ratio reels. That's all you need. It's going to work for you in the long haul. Use the slowest reel you got. If you're going to buy one, buy something in the sixes. I wouldn't suggest fives, but sixes would be better. In the footage that I'm going to show you right now, it looks like I'm reeling that bait really fast, but you got to take into consideration something. When I'm in my bass boat and I am throwing ahead of the boat and my trolling motor is moving towards my bait, my gear ratio of my reel is now changed. Even though it looks like I'm moving fast, the fact that I've got my trolling motor 60, 70% moving towards my bait, it's not moving as fast as it looks. So you may see me winding this fast and you're like, God, he said slow down, but it looks like he's moving really fast. You'll notice that my bait is always ahead of me and I'm moving my boat towards me. If you don't believe this, what I want you to do is I want you to go outside, take your bait caster, throw your whatever bait out in the yard, in your grass, and reel towards it and walk towards it. You'll notice when you're walking towards it, your bait doesn't move as fast as it does when you're just standing still and you start reeling. With that being said, when you look at this, when you look at the footage, you see me reeling the chatterbait and it looks like I'm smoking it back to the boat. Chatterbait's just... I'm just keeping up with it. So think about those things when you're fishing the bait. How fast the trolling motor is moving. Your kayak, even if you're bank fishing and you're moving towards the bait, you're changing the speed of the bait by how fast not only are you reeling, but how fast you're moving towards or not moving towards the bait. It's affecting the speed of the bait as well. Secondly, now this is something you may not think about. It only matters sometimes. I like the 13 fishing reels because they have a higher line capacity. The spool is pretty deep. It's pretty wide compared to, like, let's just say the Shimano that I have right here. This is an old Shimano, so I know it's an older Shimano, but the spool is really shallow on these. Usually when I'm fishing a chatterbait, I'm probably using fairly big lines, 17 to 20 pound test. Almost never go over 20 pound test, but when I'm using that big line, it's a big diameter, and sometimes I'm making long cast, and the less line you have on your reel, it changes the gear ratio of your reel. Okay, so if I've got a line capacity that is bigger, I have a more consistent line take up ratio throughout my cast. That's a very complicated way of saying I like to have to be able to put more line on my spool for when I make long casts, because I know that I'm not gonna, one, throw to the end of my spool, to the knot on my spool. Secondly, it's gonna keep my gear ratio more consistent throughout my cast. And you know, it's sometimes I cut off line throughout the fishing day. I'll cut off, you know, 10-foot section when I retie, and just being able to have a lot more line on there with the bigger line diameter, it just works out better. if I was just flipping my chatterbait around just target-oriented fishing, it's not that big of a deal. But when I'm fan casting, making very long casts, I feel like having more line capacity is a better deal. One thing that I did like about the Lewes Tournament Pro had the little dial on the side to adjust the centrifugal brakes or adjust the cast control. I like that, especially if I was doing the like skipping docks or making more like a presentation that's more precise. I may switch that several times through the day. So I just felt like I had better cast control and I could change it on the fly. Going inside of the reel and changing the cast control or the brakes is not exactly the most convenient. I've had a lot of mishaps with that where you drop the face of the reel in the water or the spool comes out and then the line backlashes on the spool when you're trying to adjust it. It can be a little aggravating. So it was nice switching the dial on the side of the reel so that I could get a different feel out of the reel. I hope that helps you pick out the correct reel to fish your chatterbaits. Just remember that your chatterbait reel doesn't necessarily have to be boxed into that. You're going to be able to use it for some of the other baits that I'm going to talk about later on. Secondly, look for a reel that's a little bit slower. We talked about look for a reel, especially if you're going to plan to cast that chatterbait a long way. Since you're going to be using fairly bigger line, use for one that has a bigger line capacity. It's going to keep your cast, your gear ratio more consistent throughout your cast. And lastly, if it's important to you, think about how you adjust the casting brakes on your reel. Do you need to be able to adjust them quite often? You might want to look one with a side dial. If it's not that important to you, you can set it up and kind of go and do whatever your thing is. It's probably best to use one with the adjustable brakes on the inside. All right, that's everything I've got for you guys when it comes to choosing a chatterbait reel.